In the last part of this very long tutorial, we are ready to manage alarms from the practical point of view. Since there are three types of reset, auto reset, user reset, and with the counter, we can manage three alarms, one for each type. We can manage the high temperature alarm with the auto reset, antifreeze with the user reset, and broken probe the one with the counter. So the high temperature alarm is a symbol. We can define a fixed limit, 15 degrees. We won't, let's say, waste time to create a parameter, but because basically a limit is something like the set point and the proportional band. So just to speed up a little the exercise, I will use a fixed limit, 15. So the alarm will be active when the water inlet temperature will be higher than 15, greater or greater than 15. Antifreeze when the temperature is less than or just less than 3 degrees, and the broken probe when the probe is connected or disconnected, basically. As usual, there is a slide that summarizes the steps to follow to manage, in this case, the alarms. Step 1, in C-Strategy and in C-Mask, we have to write the code and mask to manage the alarm mask, the logs, and all the support functions. Maybe you remember this file masks, so we have to write this. The suggestion is start from the project template, because the project template already has these five masks inside and all other things. And this is what we have done. The chiller alarms is based on the project template. So step 1 is done. Step 2, for each alarm, in this strategy, in the alarm node, we have to add a new alarm. Open the alarms page. You can see that the project template, the chiller alarms that is based on the project template, has already a couple of alarms regarding the number of writing in the retained memory. Anyway, we have to add a new alarm. Actually, is one for each alarm. We have to manage three alarms. So we can manage three. So the first is called alarm high temperature. Here this is the type of reset. So I say that the first is auto reset. Okay, it was already auto reset. Edge could be positive or negative. Positive means that the alarm starts when the alarm variable, later will be better, what is it, the alarm variables change from false to true. Negative is when change from true to false. Typical is positive. A description. Okay, type of alarm is obvious. Counter max and time value is used in the third type of alarm. Here are the two variables that you can save together with the alarm, and that's all. Second is the alarm anti-freeze. This one is user reset, positive like before. Freeze, also in this case counter not used. In this exercise we want to use the sample variable. Next and last is the alarm probe. This one is reset with a counter, broken probe. This time you have to set the number and the time. So till two times the reset will be auto reset. That's it. And starting from the third will be user reset, like exactly like this one. The slide states that for each alarm, the system creates a new global variable, which data type is ALM. So let's have a look to the global variables. Let me use the filter. You can see that there are three variables, which name is the name of the alarms. The data type is not a elementary data type like Boolean, integer, and so on, but it is a derived data type. To be more precise, it is a structure. The evidence that this is a structure is this plus. Plus is used also for the array, actually. So with the plus, we can expand that structure. So the alarm high temperature, click inside has two fields, the trigger and the active. But we can see that in the data type structure, there is the real data type ALM, which fields are trigger and active. Next step, we have to manage the trigger variable. I remind you that the trigger variable is the one that switch on the buzzer and also the alarm LED. It's also the one that switch on the corresponding active variable, that is the one that let the alarm description be visible in the active alarm, but we will see later. So we can start with the high temperature alarm. So for the high temperature alarm, the alarm variable is AL underscore high temp. So we have to manage the alarm high temp dot trigger. Also in this exercise, I prefer to use the structured text language. We create a specific PO for that. So we add a PO in ST, structured text. I will rename immediately with a better name, alarms, for example. The order here, execution order, is good just after temperature. Well, we can start with a comment. High temperature alarm. So these are the markers, the beginning and the final marker for the comment. And then we have to write the code. So the alarm is active when the water inlet temperature is greater than or greater than equal the limit that is 15 degrees. So if, by the way, if you don't remember the syntax of the statement, I remind you that there is in the toolbox possibility to place the template. So you could just replace the comment with what the comment states. But I prefer to start from scratch. So if the expression is, or the condition is, the temperature is greater than, I prefer greater than or equal, the limit that is 15, then what the trigger variable of alarm high temp trigger is, that is alarm active, else the same flag trigger is false and if. Well, it's enough. What I'm doing here is just a very simple alarm management. It is not real. You want to see something like this in a real application, because a real application has at least a delay for the alarm, so the alarm doesn't start immediately, just as soon as the temperature is greater than the limit. So as a delay and or a differential that is start at 15 and ends 1 degree below. But anyway, this is an exercise. The message that I wanted to tell you is you have, the application has to manage the trigger. how the strategy manage the trigger, what is the logic behind it, doesn't matter. Just manage the trigger. So for this exercise, for this tutorial, this is enough. Next alarm is the anti-freeze. Well, anti-freeze is very, very similar. I could copy and paste and change some letter, but I prefer to write again from scratch. So if the temperature is this time is less than or less than or equal the limit, that is 3 degrees, then what? Then the the antifreeze dot trigger is true, else it is antifreeze trigger equal false. And if next is the broken probe alarm, so how to detect if a probe is working or not? One possible way is to consider the range of temperature that the probe is able to read. We are using an NTC sensor. If I remember well, it is able to read values in the range minus 40 to plus 90. So we could check if the temperature is less than or equal minus 40, or temperature is greater than 90. Then the trigger is true, also the trigger is false. Another way is using this a specific value that the input-output subsystem returns in case of the NTC sensor is short-circuited or not connected, that are something like minus 9999 and plus 9999. So if the temperature is equal one of these two values, means that the probe is broken. The third way is what we use is to use the built-in support of a broken probe in C-Suite. Maybe you remember that when in one of the first exercises we have used the variable water inlet temperature here in the input number one, we have used the variable property, the channel direction, the channel type, and we skip the error variable. So this is the time to use this. What is the error variable? Actually, a better name could be status variable. Anyway, the input-output subsystem gives to this variable a value that depends on the probe status. The possible values are listed in the help. Editors, input output editor, configure fixed universal input, and here is the list of the values. So 10, the value 10 means no error, so the probe is working. And while a negative values represent error condition, probe not connected, probe short circuit, overflow, underflow, and so on. For the passive probes like the one that we are using, the NTC sensor, the values, the possible values are these two: probe not connected, or the wire is cutted, or probe short circuit. So we could check if the value of the variable is minus 1 or minus 2. But what we will implement in this exercise is a simplified management of alarm. That is, the important is to know if the probe is working or not. Doesn't matter why it doesn't work. Short circuit, not connected, or whatever else. So what we can do is simply check if the variable is 10 or not 10 or different than 10. 10 means no errors, no problem, while a different value means that there is a problem. So the first step is create a variable that we can use here where the system can write the value. So we can go in strategy. Since the variable temperature variable is called W in temp, I could call the other in a similar way. So I will copy and paste, just rename to water in the temperature error. The name of the property is error, so I will call error. Data type could be any data type, any integer data type with the sign. Since the value could be negative, it must be with the sign. So a possible data type, a good data type, could be int. Also short integer as well as also double integer could be good, but I will use integer because most of the time this is the data type that is used. Int. Read write, no, because we don't need to write it in the mask. Retain, no, because it continually take a value. Input output is already selected, and this is good because we need in the C design. That's all. Just save so that I can see it here. Here is. So the water in the temperature error, we take the value 10 when the probe is working, different than 10 if the probe is not working. So now we can go back here and replace this with if the error variable is different than 10 where 10 is no error. Different than 10 means that there is the alarm. So the probe trigger is true, else probe trigger is false. I could use here rather than this. If is equal 10, the trigger is false, and vice versa. But I prefer to use this way because for consistency with other. So here there is true, false, true, false, true, false. So I have the same sequence. After that, another couple of words regarding the 10, because we have to remember that 10 means no errors. There is another way to do the same thing, that is using a derived data type, sorry, is using the defined words. We already talked about the array, actually we don't talk so much about the array, but about the structure. Now we can use a defined word. A defined word is a constant. And actually the standard IEC 61131 calls this thing constants. In this implementation of the standard, they are called defined words. They are something like variable with a predefined value. The difference is that we can't change the value of the variable, so we can't write somewhere in the code R file access equal something, no, because they are constant. The advantage is that you can use a value using a name. We can see that there are a lot of predefined words. There is a block of this that start with IO that regards the input output. So all these values regards the alarms. For example, you see here -1 probe not connected is -1 is open, okay. 2 probe short circuit, minus 2 short circuit. So for each error value or error or status value, there is a corresponding constant. Also for value 10, that is no error, there is a corresponding defined word, input, output, or no error. So we could use in the code, rather than the value, we could use the defined word, because if you remember that the defined word regarding the input output subsystem begins with IO, just type IO like right now, and I think that the name of the defined word is enough to remember the purpose. Open, so probe not connected, short circuit, no error. So you can guess that this means no error, that is the good value for the probe. So IO no error is equal 10, that means no errors. Okay, so it was not mandatory to change the constant with the defined words. It was just the opportunity to use this. Next and the last step, we have to update the alarm number and alarm description classes that are the ones that are used in the active alarm to show the description of the alarm and also the ID of the alarm. So open CMask classes, we can filter alarm, we can start from this, the alarm description, because it is easier to understand. This user class uses only the resource used on int. In one of the previous exercises, we have used the resource used on bool for the boolean. Int is for integer, but basically it's the same. The difference is rather than have only two values for the boolean, we can have more. So here we have to add a string, a new item for each alarm. So the first is for the high temperature, and then anti-freeze and broken probe. There is a very important requirement regarding this modification, that is the number and the sequence must be the same of the alarm node. That is, if here there are 5 alarms, we must have 5 items in the resource used on int with the same sequence. So alarm retain and its description, alarm retain write and its description, high temperature and the description of high temperature, and so on. You can imagine that if you reverse two strings, you will see something completely different. For example, the alarm antifreeze starts and you see a different description. Well, we can continue with the other. Is alarm number, so this is the ID that appear in the top left corner of the mask. We can add other strings. So we could use the same style of the previous ID, that is a number, AL3, AL4, and so on. If you prefer, you can use something like this, like alarm high temperature, alarm anti-freeze, alarm broken probe, okay, and so on. It's just a string that identifies the alarm. Now we are ready to test. So I will test in the real controller, so I can test also the broken probe alarm. I can start building mask, and to build online also the strategy. I'm sure that there are no errors, so I can go here immediately. We'll upload this configuration, that in this case it is the only configuration that is available. I am connected via internet, the controller is this one, 1010649, upload. In the meantime it uploads, I can start Oh, no, is already here. The CPCO virtual display. Remember, you have to type the IP of the controller. Appear the main menu, and what we need is here in the PGD. Okay, we can start from a stable condition that is around the set point, so no high temperature alarm, anti-freeze, and so on. In a stable condition like this, the buzzer is off, and you hear it off, LED is off, and also no alarm. Very good. Now I can start to test the first alarm. I can start from the high temperature. High temperature is auto reset. So if the alarm condition is active, I will hear the buzzer. Here is the buzzer. The red LED blink while the alarm, if the alarm goes away, no buzzer, no LED, no message. So we can see the alarm message only if I enter in the active alarm while the alarm is active. So now I can see the message. Temperature down. No alarm. No message. So this is the auto reset alarm. Now we can go on with the second one, the antifreeze, that is a user reset. So if the temperature goes down below the limit, alarm. So even if the temperature go back to a good value, you can see that since the alarm, the reset type is user, the buzzer remains on, the LED remains on, we are able to enter in the active alarm and see the description. This is user reset, so we have to manually reset it by pressing the alarm button for 3 seconds here in the active alarm, or 3 seconds here, but in this case it will reset all the alarms. Ok, in this case it is the same because we have just one alarm. So press 1, 2, 3 and no alarm. Well, that was the user reset. Next and last is the auto reset with the counter. So this time I have to be able to trigger the alarm 3 times in less than 2 minutes, because the first 2 times will be auto reset, like you see here in the picture. The third time within 2 minutes, in the third time it will become user reset, exactly like the antifreeze. Well, let's try. Now I am disconnecting the probe simulator. Disconnect. Here is the broken probe. You may see also the other alarms, because now the application is reading a very low temperature, so that arises also the antifreeze. But now we have to give the focus to the broken probe. So now I'm reconnecting the probe simulator. I expect that the alarm goes away. Ok, infatti, you see that the broken probe went away. Well, second time I'm disconnected the probe simulator. This is the second time. Here is the broken probe, is still auto reset. I am reconnecting, so should go away this one. In fact, it disappear the broken probe. Now I'm disconnecting it for the third time. The probe. Here is the broken probe. I am reconnecting. Okay, this is the third time. So I expect that the reset expect that the reset is user. In fact, you see that the probe is connected, but the message is still active because the reset of the broken probe alarm is user now. So I have to press 3 seconds here or 3 seconds here to reset the alarm. 1, 2, 3, and no alarms. So the first two times were user reset, the third time in the period of 2 minutes became user reset. Well, we have seen the support to alarms in C Suite and how it is implemented in the project template. We believe that you won't need to modify it, but in any event, since it is a template, you can modify it. For example, if you don't need the ID in the top left corner, you can delete this class. If you need an additional line of description for the alarms, you can just add another variable and class like this just here below. If you need to edit, modify the behavior of the keys, you need some additional information. That is the two database, the two support database, one for the active alarm and the other for the logs, and then the support functions, system function for this database. We can have a very quick look to this. For example, we can see what is the function of the alarm key at terminal level. We know that when we press the alarm key, we enter in the no alarm mask or in the active alarm mask according if there is at least one alarm or zero alarms. So let's see what is the function that the system calls at the terminal level when we press the alarm key. The function is check active alarm. So we can go in the code, search for check active alarm. So first of all, it reads the how many alarms, active alarms there are using the system function get alarms count. This one, get alarms count. In this case, it would return 3, 1, 2, 3, because there are 3 active alarms. So if the number of alarms is greater than 0, that is, there is at least one alarm, it will set the status of the LED number 12, that is the alarm LED. Somewhere in the user manual there is the mapping of the LED on the display. Set to the value 1, that means fixed on. The other possibility are fixed off and blinking. So at least one alarm, the alarm LED is switched on. And then get alarm info of what alarm? Of alarm IDX, that is one. So at the beginning it reads the information of the very first active alarm. So it will return the timestamp and also the alarm ID. And then go to loop the active alarms. So there is at least one alarm, so it goes to the active alarm mask. Else means no alarm. In that case, the alarm LED is switched off, and the system shows the no alarm mask. Okay, that's enough. But I repeat that normally you don't need to modify the alarm management of the project template. Well, that's enough for this very long exercise regarding alarms. Thank you for watching.